Hello everyone, it's Chuck Thunder, and we're going to start off a new Let's Play series with Farming Simulator 19. This is going to be a series where I start from scratch with a new farm. I'm going to do farm manager here, where I have good funds but no land. I'm going to immediately pay off my loan that I get in the beginning of the game too, so I'm even having some more challenge. And that's where we're going to start from, so let's get started. Let's pick a map. We're going to go with the Griffin, Indiana map. This is a mod map that I picked up. I like flat, open areas. This one I think is going to be a good map to start. Continue. Chuck Thunder. Alright, just a real quick showing of all the mods that I have. Some of the more important ones are like Auto Drive. These are all assets, cultivator, field cultivator, creator, the pallets production, I guess. Firewood's a great one. Global company is important. Seasons is going to be on here, guys. That's the one big thing. Lumberjack. Mobile workshop's always good. It's mostly assets. The real mower is great, so that way I can cut down all the bushes. Seasons, like I said, is going to be the most important one. Because that is my goal, is to try to work through seasons, but we're going to change some settings about the game a little bit. And Workshop Trapper, that's a great one too. So we're going to change those settings. Let's get started. It should be loaded up in a little bit. What I'm going to do is I'm going to immediately change some of the season settings. Something that I think is a little more appropriate. There are some things about seasons I like, there's some things about seasons I don't like. I get why they do some of them because of the realism. But immediately, I'm going to go to Alt S. This is the seasons menu. We have 9-day seasons on. I'm going to turn it to 6-day seasons. That's one thing I'm going to change. And then crop damage, I like. Crop moisture I turn off. Now the reason why I do this is because this like just really limits whether or not you can harvest the crop. If the crop is too wet, then you can't harvest it. If it's obviously raining, you can't harvest. But even if it's dry, the rain has stopped, you can't harvest because it has to be moisture less than 20, so then you gotta worry about how it dries. And so I like to turn that off. And I think that's gonna be it for the seasons menu right now. As you see, now we have 6-day seasons, so that's what we're going to start with. Okay, back up. I heard a car start up, but I don't see a car. Weird. Alright, and then we're going to go to the regular settings menu. Change a few things here. I like to have dollar miles acres. All of this sounds good. Camera sensitivity, easy arm controls, good. GUI, environment, volume master. Hopefully this first episode records well. I don't need to mess with those. Alright, and then I like to change this to all off. I don't want them to buy anything. I want to be able to refill it all myself. Timescale 5 is fine. Automatic engine starting. Auto saving is fine. Periodic plowing I don't like because I don't understand why. I mean, I get it. You want to plow frequently, every so often, to like really till things over, but plowing in this game is really, really crummy when you're creating new fields and stuff like that. I mean, doing a new field that's already created, periodic plowing is okay, but I don't feel like it's really necessary. Cultivating is enough for me. Lime is fine. Weeds in these seasons I like to turn off, basically because in the developer game, when you get weeds, you just get weeds over across the whole field. In seasons, you get weeds sporadically. And so you have to like treat for weeds as they come up, which I get it is how you would typically do. You'd have somebody go out and pick the weeds from the field on a regular basis. But this is just too much micromanagement for me. I like to just plant the stuff and then either as a stage weed it all or not weed it at all. So there we go. We're going to change the save game. We'll change the name of the save game to Let's Play Farm Sim 19. A couple capitals and non-capitals, but whatever. Just is done. Alright. So, first off, do we have any loans we need to pay? Because I'd like to get that paid off, yes. So let's go back and repay our loan. I'd like to challenge myself a bit. We don't need all 125 million. Then we're going to go back. Now we got to buy some land. Now, I was looking at this map once before, and I want to have a map of some property in which that has some trees on it for me to make a little bit, excuse me, a little bit of money. So some of these properties are like all field, and that's great, but it is early on in the game. I don't know how much I'm going to be able to afford, and I'd like some buildings already. So this property here is a good potential. I could probably buy both of these and get a limited field potential here. So, but before we go buying both, yeah, let's just buy both. Buy this one and buy this one. That leaves me with some money. 90,000, so with the basic minimums. And then we need to get ourselves a tractor. Now, early game, I downloaded a few mods. So there's some cheaper options out there for small tractors, like some of these here. Universal is obviously the cheapest and also one of the weakest. Sorry, text message. So these here are decent. They're small. Jeez, my phone's going off like crazy. This one's not bad either. These two are good solid options. A good all-around tractor probably would be one of these. And then if I really needed to, I could get a second tractor. The Universal would just be a good tow back and forth tractor, while this guy can be my most customizable. So I think we're going to start with a reasonable tractor. 4x2. Just, I guess, whether or not it has four-wheel drive or two-wheel drive. Around here, it's pretty flat. Save ourselves some money. I'd like to have it so that it has some weight in the front, I guess. I can get a little bit larger. Front load attacher, possibly. We could always add it later. But right now, we will buy this tractor. Alright. And then, we obviously need something to seed a field. Now, I like to get ones that do both. Seed and sow. Or seed and cultivate. So, if we have to get one that's relatively expensive, that does that. This is always a really cheap option, just to seed. Spread seeds over the top. What is this one? A 3 meter. See, our tractor technically isn't strong enough to pull that. Technically, but it can pull this one. So this, and this one also can do fertilizer at the same time. This is, I think, the one we're gonna go with. It costs us a little extra, as long as it gets a fertilizer, saves us some trouble by fertilizing the same stage. That's important. Alright, so we got that. And then we will need at least, I think, another. Let's go back. Let's go ahead and get started. So at least we have a tractor. Hooked up. Oh, you know what? Before we go, more important than anything else will be to buy some seed. So I have the pallet mod installed. I like to get seeds from the pallet. And we'll get fertilizer on a pallet. Fertilizer filled should get the majority of the piece. You'll know when you've gotten close enough. And the lid pops open. There we go. It's from the seat side. Almost. Alright. So now I have everything we need to get soaring on some cut fields. So first and foremost, is getting started. So just to learn where we are, it's straight down this road here. It's a pretty decent tractor to start. It's not super strong. I'm definitely going to need something. I mean, really, one tractor is all you're going to need if you only have like one or two fields to start. But I like to have a second tractor so I can do some other things around the fields while I can. But we might get a second tractor. We might get that universal. Just have a really cheap, weak tractor to do basic trailering back and forth, whether it's for logging or for actual taking stuff back and forth. Oh, let's put that car up there. Let's go on there. Can't make this first left and see that green building there. That's our fields to start. We have the field directly straight ahead, and then we have the field to the right. I'd like to get the smaller field started first, because I do believe we have enough in here to start this field, possibly finish this field, so we are going to go do that. Now they put a lot of these entranceways here like this, well, that suggests that you should be seeding the field this direction, but that's what we're going to do. I know that it could seed the other direction because I did a test plot on this field earlier when others came, so I don't know that I'll do that. Set it up so we'll do it. Hire our worker. Make sure we get started. Okay. There we go. Getting started. So now, let's get our next situation going. So, another small tractor here. I can get these guys too. These guys are really customizable, which is kind of nice. But they're just really weak. So we're going to get this universal. I really don't like the colors on this thing, but you don't have many options, and it costs money to change it. So you can get a front loader, but I don't suggest doing that. Keep narrow tires on in case we need to get in the field. Front loader attacher is really pointless. Add some weight to the front, I guess, if I really had to, but I could always do it later. Alright, so we'll just straight up buy the $8,000 tractor, and then we have $20,000 to buy a trailer. Now, I like trailers that are, like, useful in multiple fashions. I didn't download a lot of mods that give me that trailer, kind of trailer. Sorry guys, my cats are jumping around and fighting each other. I've got a few trailers here, like here's a logging trailer. These are attachments for trucks. This is for a John Deere. This is for another truck. These are regular trailers. Meant to go with pickup trucks. Straw bales, pallets, and other things. Doesn't seem to have. This trailer is, I think, a little too small for my liking. Comes with a lot of options. But I'm not a fan of that trailer. I think I'm just going to go with the traditional flatbed trailer here. As they earn more money, I should, but I feel like I should invest the money in now to make it a full trailer. I can do logging with this trailer, I've done it before. this for now. Because we need a basic trailer. We're also going to bring back these items. Now, normally, oh, well, I can pick it up. These, I guess, aren't that heavy. Or maybe it was auto on. Yeah. I like super strength on. Now, there's no reason why that I don't think this makes sense to use super strength in this scenario, but super strength when lifting trees, maybe not so much. In this case, I think it makes a lot of sense for two reasons. One, they're bags. You can imagine that if we were at this place, we could load this trailer one bag at a time. Obviously not pick up the whole pallet at the same time, but we could easily just pick up these bags and load them onto this trailer, you know, by hand. It just would take a little bit longer. So it's not impossible to imagine that. But I think in the case of lifting trees, that might be the situation. So I want to also here, I'm going to use my auto drive mechanic. Turn it on, and I can begin recording. I'm going to set up this location as the shop, so that way it is retrievable. Now, one thing I didn't do is turn on traffic. I like traffic because it's more realistic, but I like to turn it off because when you're using auto drive, it's really annoying when you're fixing one accident. It's because it's stuck behind a car that is blocked by another one of your vehicles or something. It's just tied up. I don't think we have a short trip though that we have for us to go to and from the shop, so that's good. So getting equipment and this is going to take too long for us. As well as I think there are some shopping, basic shopping places to sell along this road for the future tonight. So it's clear, let's do a turn. See how I turn like that would normally be a complete turn. Try to keep this in order as much as possible. Here. We're going to need to get more from the shop, so let's turn it around. Back to the other shop, I'm going to need to pick up a couple of things. I might want to pick up a sprayer for fertilizing, or maybe a spreader for fertilizing. Here's why I need something else, because there are three growth stages of fertilizing to do in this season, and I will need fertilizer on a regular basis, I think, the most. So I might want to grab a fertilizer spreader and use a one that I saw initially called Lizard Spreader. That is one of those back-mounted bucket spreaders that spreads by spreading material from the back. It will also do lime, so it's a good item for us because it will take a lot of park for us, so we might want to come out. And I'm not sure if my field needs line at the moment either, but we will check that. In the meantime, I'll get the spreader on top of the ground. I think for our uses, it will be the majority of our spreader for us. What we can get. Alright. Now, I said for cedars, that was in here, this kind of cedar. This one only does seeding. However, if you go to fertilizer technology, yeah, we have all these other fertilizers, but there is the one I was talking about that does lime and fertilizer. It's really cheap. It's only 3,000. We can afford that. It has a spread width of 18, which is pretty reasonable compared to some of these other ones that only have a 12 meter spread and this was a 24. So for the price, this is really good. So we'll go ahead and buy that. While we're also here, I think we're going to check our field, make sure it doesn't need liming. It's being planted at the moment, it is fertilized, there are no weeds. Does it need lime? No, the small field doesn't, but the bigger field does. And I am going to want to start doing that field at some point. It's not as detrimental, but while we're here, we might as well top off on it. So let's do that. Go to pallets. Again, there are lime pallets. And if I have to leave it here for now, we can do that. It's not a big deal. This will run out of line very quickly, but it is something that we can consider. So let's go to drive, get to another drive. Should be doing it on its own. We need one. How are we doing, too? Pretty good. Yeah, I've missed a few spots, but nothing that I can't fix. Again, in seasons you have 3 days, or 6 days, we're doing 6 day seasons, so we have 6 days to get this fully seeded, get that fully seeded, and there's a few things I still have to do while this is going on. So I have this trailer here. It's not going to be doing much today, but actually it might be using it soon, but I have plans for it, so I'm going to put, whoa, just throwing pallets. Put this here. Oops. That's not going to do anybody good if that's on the roof. Alright. And then, what I want to do is, I want to clear these trees. This is going to be a little bit of work, but it's also going to be a little bit of money. I'll have to invest $1,000 into a chainsaw and we'll cut down these trees. Now, another thing I explored on this map, there are some trees that you just can't cut down. Because they're too close to the main road, you don't technically, I guess, own them. So every tree here you see here I can cut down, with the exception of these little guys here, as far as I can remember. That one I might be able to cut down, I can't recall now. If I remember too, the house is not accessible, so I can't sleep. So we're going to work through the night. Might have to download a mod to sleep. Alright. So we're here. Put down. Maybe right now. Just getting our basic setup for today. Let's get back and get a logging trailer of some kind. Because we're going to need to do that. Oh, this is a nice cheap trailer. It's the cheapest trailer I have. I could do a logging trailer. It's a lot easier than using the flatbed truck trailer. Plus, we have the money. We don't have it for the more expensive ones, but I have the money for this one, so we're just going to buy it. Hate the color. $50, I think we could spend the $60 to $50 and change the color. Chainsaw. A chainsaw will do. And we also don't have a way to store our grain, so we're going to need to buy a place to store grain. Now, I've downloaded a few different kinds of storage silos to do this with that are I can afford. And here we go. Small guy ought to do fine for our use. I don't want it to be in the way, but I need it to be. So I don't know, it's an odd shaped field, so. Well, it's an odd shaped silo. Here's something else I also have to change up. Control G. I need to change this. Activate Extend Placeable. This is Global Company. It allows me to place my stuff wherever. Because there's nothing more annoying than being limited, being told that you can't place things certain places. So now I can place it literally anywhere, even on other fields. Let's see, where do we want this to go? I don't want it to be in the path of seeders and harvesters and all that stuff. So, this will be fine, so long as we're harvesting the field long ways like this. And it's kind of the same shape no matter what. I think we'll be okay. I don't want it here because I have an auto drive path there. So, we might just place it... place it like right here. Yeah, I think that's reasonable for now. We can clear those trees first. Another thing about seasons, if you buy anything that you know you don't want, you can easily return it. Within the first few hours, if I return that wood trailer that I bought, then it'd be just going to be oh, shoot. I'm sorry. I threw my tractor, everybody. This is going to be the first tree we attempt to take. Maybe we'll do that for the next episode. But everybody, we're on our way to getting started. We have the basics. We can now get things going. The only thing we don't have a way to do is to harvest. So I'm just going to probably, because it does take a while to do, I'm probably going to have to make a lot of money before the next 6 days. And that's going to be a bunch of logging. Hopefully these trees give me enough money to... do what I want to do. Same thing with this field over here. I'm hoping these trees are something I could trim down. If not, I will find some places on this map which have trees that I can cut down and make a little bit of extra money. Contracts, this is something we could do too. Yep, contracts are absolutely something we could do. So, we're going to make a little bit of money in the next couple episodes, and we are going to get ourselves started. Thanks everyone for watching. This has been Chuck Dunder. I have to stop my cats from chasing each other around the room. So, everyone, thanks again for watching. This has been Chuck Dunder. Take care.